is Saturday, September the 25th, 1976, in Jackson, Mississippi, at the Holiday Inn North, the Mississippi AFL-CIO Special COPE Convention, 1976.
Testing, 1, 2, testing, 1, 2.
No, he says leave it just about on 7, 6 or 7. Testing, 1, 2, 3, testing, 1, 2, 3. You getting it good?
Yes.
Now that's the way it should reflect, okay? Testing, 1, 2, 3, 4. Testing, 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Testing, 1, 2, 3. Testing, 1, 2, 3, 6, 8, 9.
Guide us and lead us.
very distinguished congresswoman from the state of Texas by the name of Barbara Jordan came to our state. She addressed a meeting here in our Coliseum of a group of mostly black business people. We have a little hassle going on down there, and I was involved in it. Eventually, they get a ticket. Barbara worked out to get a ticket off on where Barbara Jordan had come to Mississippi to make those tickets. But the point I want to leave with you is simply this, and that remark, and her remarks in this town, Barbara Jordan said that done had two strikes on us in the election in 1976. That had a big bearing on the decision made here a year ago. should be top priority for this organization, that we all do everything that we can, humanly possible, to make sure that each and every qualified voter, our members, their families, and their friends, that they do go to the polls on November the 2nd, and that they do vote for Jimmy Carter for president of this United States. Thank you very much. Thank you. prevented from making an official endorsement. Like, you know, we are realists in our state. We knew that we ought to be involved, and if we ought to do what we could to support the candidate that we felt was the best man for the job that was running in Mississippi. You know, the first thing I did was, I didn't take somebody else's word for it. I picked up the telephone and called her name. I said, "Her, what about Jimmy Carter? What kind of governor was it? What is the Georgia labor movement doing in this situation? What are your recommendations?" He said, "Scott, Jimmy Carter was one of the best governors that the state of Georgia ever had. That he worked very closely with the labor movement in my state, and as president of my state AFL-CIO, I can tell you that I know him very well. I've been in many, many conferences with him, and I'd recommend to you that you do everything that you can for Jimmy Carter." Well, again, in the absence of being able to take an official position, I'm letting the secret out of the room now. The thing that I did was to make some names and addresses that many of you are available as the people in here running the organization. There wasn't any accident. But Jim Goff and the other people putting the corner organization together made contact with many of you. That's our account. You know, frankly, at that time, everybody didn't think Jimmy Carter had much of a shot. We all thought that he perhaps would be the number two man. But you know, we have to give the guy a check. He works. He works. We have to give this guy a lot of check. Talk. He's got people. There's a few people in the labor movement in places like Pennsylvania. I'm not too sure they're speaking to Herb Mabry yet. But Herb Mabry will have that more to do with Jimmy Carter down the state of Pennsylvania than anybody else knows. Because he's got patience. Think about his expenses. The governor's joint. He's anxious to come here today. Because we think it's important. We think that he'll provide you with some information that you need. That will help you when you go back home and attempt to convince people to vote for Jimmy Carter on November the 2nd. Ladies and gentlemen, there's much more I can say, but I'd be infringing upon Herb Mabry's time. It is my pleasure at this time to present to you the Honorable Herb Mabry, the President of the Georgia State AFL-CIO. Let's give him a hand. President Ramsey, Director Sala, Secretary Treasurer Knight, Reverend Jackson, Senior. be on welfare. I believe that 99% of the people in America today want a job. They don't want welfare. They don't want you and I handing them something, or their children have to go out and beg for something to wear or something to eat. And I say that you and I, we aren't doing the job that we were put on earth to do, to help the people that are not able to help themselves, unless we go from one end of this country to the other, carrying the message and telling the people to get off their back end and get out here and get registered and go to the polls November 2nd and vote for Jimmy Carter as president of the United States. Labor movement of America ever said idly by
important thing of all, get out and vote, not only in the presidential race, get out and get involved. When you leave this meeting, walk to Mondale. Jim Fallon and all have had a meeting in Atlanta, and I keep ramming, but I mean, the things that's important to us. We're having an IUD meeting at the Hilton Hotel in Atlanta a month and a half ago. Walter Mondale had been somewhere, he was driving and going to the airport in Atlanta. He passed the motel. I don't know, Mark, did he? Well,
Here and ask the reps to make sure they sign. traditional bedrock of American foreign policy, defense, promotion of human rights and human freedom, have been sacrificed to political expedience. The role of the United States as a moral and political leader of the free world is in serious question. The remedy for each of these ills is the election of a president and vice president of the United States committed to a platform that will turn the country around, restore health to the economy, bring respect and decency to government institutions, reassert human values in foreign policy, and restore justice and equality under the law. The Democratic National Convention, which concluded on July 15th, nominated candidates and adopted a platform committed to these goals. Therefore, this executive council hereby endorses the candidacy of Jimmy Carter and Walter Mondale for election as president and vice president. As this statement indicates, the AFL-CIO has endorsed the candidacy of Jimmy Carter and Walter Mondale for president and vice president. This endorsement was reaffirmed by the unanimous vote of the AFL-CIO General Board at a special meeting in Washington, August 31st. Whereas, on May 22nd, the delegates in attendance at a special call Coke convention in Biloxi unanimously endorsed the candidacy of Gerald Messer for Congress in Mississippi's 5th Congressional District. The chief reason for this endorsement centered around the fact that Trent Lott, the incumbent, has compiled a very bad voting record during the past 4 years, while Gerald Blessing has compiled an excellent voting record as a member of the Mississippi Legislature during the past 5 years. Whereas the executive board of the Mississippi AFL-CIO has carefully reviewed the action of the AFL-CIO Executive Council, as well as the actions of the May 22nd Cole Convention, and already agreed with both decisions. Whereas in reviewing the bill congressional district content, the executive board took note of the fact that Trent Lott, a member of the board of advisors of the Committee for Survival of a Free Congress. This committee is an anti-labor outfit which has recently organized to help defeat friendly communists from throughout the United States. Now, therefore, be it resolved that this convention of the Mississippi AFL-CIO, assembled in Jackson on September 25th, 1976, does go on record in support of the AFL-CIO endorsement of Jimmy Carter and Walter Mondale for president and vice president, and that we will do everything humanly possible to elect these gentlemen to these two high offices. The Democrats had a representative in
like to ask that everyone here please write down this address. I'm going to ask you for an appeal. It's Harrison County, AFT. Excuse me, I didn't identify myself,
yeah,
sir.
Don't know
who you are. Ray Magalanes, Local 3261 of the Harrison County AFT. Harrison County AFT COPE Committee, 641 Forest Avenue in Biloxi. The zip code there is 39530. I'd like to mention also that I am the chairman of that committee. My state president is sitting over here, Mr. Powell, so we're pretty well organized in COPE. I'd like you to know that I spent about 3 weeks already with Gerald Blessy's campaign helping in the office. I'm now responsible for contacting 250 separate families by knocking on doors to help on Gerald Blessy's campaign. As you know, we're a new AFT local, we're a new union local in this state. We are probably the poorest union in the state. So I'm here to ask you if you would please, all of you go home, go to your organizations, put before your membership and ask an appeal from us, because we'd like to have a little bit of contributions from the other locals within the state. Now I ask this specifically for one reason. A short time back during our national or state AFT convention, the national COPE representative assured us for every dollar or 50 cents or 10 cents that we can collect in support of Gerald Blessy's campaign, they will match the fund. Our little tiny local has already contributed $400 to Gerald Blessy's campaign with the matching funds. We'd like to really get that real high. And if you'll keep this address in mind, please, and consider $5, $10, 20 cents. We get it matched, and maybe we can get some funds down there to help Gerald Blessy in the 5th Congressional District. And I thank you.